नम्रता। या आई आस्क यू क्वेश्चन, at the beginning of the discussion I asked you to explain one numerical. Why did you ask that? No, after submission of your assignment. Have you attended the discussion session? I saw you there attending the session. But when I asked you a question, that time you were not there.
Okay. So our agenda for the day is realizing logic gates using a multiplexer, and second is VHDL modeling of state machines. So this particular first topic is there. As such, it is not a part of the syllabus, but still it is very, very important, especially when students appear for interviews of core companies. That time they are asked this question especially. Okay, so it's very interesting thing. It's like a game. Okay, so first what I will do, I will explain how we can convert a suitably sized multiplexer into, say, a NAND gate, and then I will leave it to the students during the session to realize the remaining six gates.
From the tutorial, okay, contact head of the department.
Okay, so we know that So, NAND gate, NOR gate, AND gate, OR gate, NOT gate, okay. So this we are knowing since our second year of engineering, maybe before that. Okay, so these are called as universal gates. And OR and NOT are called as basic gates, and these are called as exclusive gates. Okay, and we know that if we define common inputs here, say then the Boolean equations are NAND B, NOR B, B, here we have okay. So what we will do is that first we will try to realize a NAND gate using multiplexer. So the problem statement is realize two input NAND gate using a suitably sized multiplexer. Okay, it's very simple. Graphically, we can put forth our statement like this, that this is our ansible symbol for a mux. Two inputs, one select line and one output, and we have to convert this system into okay. So from mux to NAND. Okay. So I think so in second year of engineering, your digital electronic staff had taught you that how to convert flip-flops among themselves, you know, how to convert SR into JK, JK into T, JK into D, etc. So something like this. So we can say that our raw material is a multiplexer and our expected product is a NAND gate, right? So what we have to do is this. So we know that if we define multiplexers inputs like this, so we know that I0, I1, S and Y. Similarly, here we have A, B and Y. Okay, so it is important to note that multiplexer is a three input one output system and NAND gate is a two input. Hello. Two input one output system. Okay, so raw material has three inputs and one output and our finished product has two inputs and one output. Okay, this is like something philosophical. So let us directly jump into the algorithmic steps for doing that. Okay, so if I show an example of how to convert it, you'll come to know how to convert the remaining gates. Okay, okay, so you see very very carefully what I am doing. Okay, so step number one is that whichever logic gate you want to realize, you write the truth table of that logic gate first. Okay, that's step number one. Okay, write the truth table of desired logic. Okay, so A, B and Y. Okay, so 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 0, 1. So here we have 1, 1, 1 and 0. Okay, now what you do is this. Step number two. Divide the truth table horizontally equally. Okay, see, so you divide the table like this into two parts. Okay, now carefully see that this is row number 1, row number 2, row number 3 and row number 4. If you carefully observe the first two rows, we can realize that in the first two rows, A is equal to 0, while in the next two rows, we realize that A equal to 1. Okay, and while we see that B is changing. Okay, so I again repeat that write the truth table of desired logic gate, divide that truth table equally into upper two rows and lower two rows. In the first two rows, we realize that A is equal to 0 while B is toggling from 0 to 1. Similarly, in the remaining two rows R3 and R4, again A is remaining constant at 1 while B is toggling from 0 to 1. Now what you have to do is this thing. This is a very, very important step. Okay. Now you have to compare these two columns. Okay. You have to compare these two columns. Compare column Y and column B. Okay. So what we realize is this. Okay. So in the first two rows, while A is remaining constant at 0, we see that when B is 0, Y is 1. Okay, so I will write it here. Okay, B is 0, Y is 1, and in the second row, that is R2, B is 1 and Y is 1. So as such, there is no relationship between Y and 1. So irrespective of the value of B, when A is remaining 0, Y is equal to 1. So we can conclude that when A is equal to 0, Y is equal to 1. This is the conclusion, okay, of the first two rows. Similarly, we will analyze the remaining two rows. Okay, what we say is this. So we see that when B is 0, Y is 1. When B is 1, Y is equal to 0. So we can, what we can clearly conclude? We can conclude that Y is equal to B bar. So I can very well write down that when A is equal to 1, Y is equal to B bar. Okay, so this is our conclusion. So I will again revise it for those who feel that they have not understood. Okay, I'll repeat. Okay, so write the truth table of desired logic gate. So I have written that 0011 0101. Then you divide the truth table horizontally equally, so you get two upper rows and two lower rows, and the rows R1 and R2 say that in the first two rows, A is remaining constant equal to 0, while B is toggling from 0 to 1. And in the remaining two rows, R3 and R4, A is again remaining constant but equal to 1 and B is toggling. Then next step is you compare the values in the column B and column Y. So in our case, what we see is that in the first row, B is 0, Y is 1. In the second row, B is changing to 1, but Y is still remaining 1. So we can conclude that irrespective of value of B, Y is remaining 1. So our conclusion of first two rows is when A is equal to 0, Y is equal to 1. Next two rows, what we are seeing that when B is 0, Y is 1. When B is 1, Y is 0. So Y is a complement of B. The conclusion of remaining two rows is that when A is 1, Y is equal to B. Okay. So I will write down these two conclusions here. Okay. So I will say when A is equal to 0, Y is equal to 1. When A is equal to 1, Y is equal to B bar. Now see what I do. I am going to use the basic concept of a multiplexer here. We know very well one. Okay. Right. So we clearly know that this means when select line is zero, this is sent here, and this indicates that when s equal to 1, this is sent here. Okay, this we already know. So what I will do is I will again draw the multiplexer here, and this is how I convert a 3 input 1 output system into a 2 input 1 output system. So I will apply the signal A of NAND gate here, and see now what I am doing. So when A is equal to 0, Y should be equal to 1. So what I will do is that I will put A equal to 0 here. So which input is selected? This is selected. So when A is 0, I want Y equal to 1. When A is 0, if this input is selected, that means I must connect this input to VCC or logic 1. Similarly, we see that when A is equal to 1, I want Y equal to B bar. So now, here, if A is equal to 1, this input is selected. And when this input is selected, I want that input to be B bar. Okay, I repeat that when A is equal to 0, I want Y equal to B bar. So when A is equal to 1, this is selected. So I must apply B bar here. Okay, so one way of writing is B bar here, but we know that B bar is not a ready-made signal available. So what I will do is that I will connect a NOT gate here and give a signal B here. Okay, now somebody may say, sir, how to verify that this particular solution is correct? No problem, we will verify it. So now we will solve this particular system again, and we will justify that this particular connection is actually the connection for a multiplexer converted into a NAND gate. Okay, so now what we will do, we will put all possible values of A and B, and we'll see what is output of the system, right? So 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 0, 1, okay? So we will see what is the first combination's output, 0, and B is also equal to 0, okay? 0, right? So when B is 0, you get a 1 here, and this is already 1 here, right? So when A is 0, this guy is selected and this guy is already connected to 1. So at the output, I will get 1. Change the input combinations. A is again equal to 0 and B is equal to 1 now. So when B is 1, what you get is a 0 here. Okay. So when A is 0, again, this is selected. So again, this is permanently hardwired to 1. Output is again 1. Now make A equal to 1. So A is equal to 1 and B is equal to 0. So here we get 1 here, okay, we get a 1 here and A is 1 here. So when A is 1, this is selected, and now because B is 0, the input, second input to multiply is 1, so we get a 1 here. Last combination is again 1 here, and B is also 1 here, so here we get a 0. So now because A is 1, this is selected and it is getting a 0 here, okay. So this is how we realize, right? So we see here that the output of multiplexer system is now 1110, and we know that the output of NAND gate truth table is also 1110. Okay, this is how it is. Okay, so another example for practice is this, that realize a 2 input OR gate using a MUX. Okay, same thing, that first step is I draw I write the truth table of OR gate 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 0, 1, it is 0, 1, 1, 1. Okay. So as usual, I will break it as per our algorithm. Okay. First two rows A is equal to 0. Next two rows A equal to 1. And then we compare these two columns and we see that when B is 0, Y is 0, B is 1, Y is 1. So we can very well conclude that for the first two rows, Y is equal to B. Similarly, if we analyze this third and fourth row, we realize that when B is 0, Y is 1, B is 1, Y is 1. So we can very well conclude that Y is not a function of B, but Y is equal to 1. So from this, I can conclude that if A is equal to 0, Y is equal to B, and if A equal to 1, then Y equal to 1. This is what I have to implement in a multiplexer. So it's very, very simple. Make the multiplexer. Write 0 and 1 here. Show the inputs here. And there's a select line. Apply A to the select line and these are Y. Okay, so when A is 0, Y should be equal to B. So when A is 0, this is selected. So simply apply the input B of NAND gate to the first input of multiplexer. Similarly, when A is 1, I want Y equal to 1. So when A is 1, this is selected. So you must connect this to plus VCC. Okay. So this is what is it. Okay. So I can also realize it again here. When A is 0, B is 0. So when A is 0, B is also 0 here. So you get 0 here. A is 0, B is 1. So A is 0, B is 1. So 1 will come outside. A is 1, B is 0. So when A is 1, this is selected. And this is connected permanently here. Similarly, when A is 1 and B is 1, A is 1, this is selected. And when this is selected, it is permanently hardwired to 1. So it's okay. So how it is. Okay. So similarly, for practice, you can say realizing and nor not XOR XNOR is for practice. Okay, now question will come. Answer to this is, one can practice structural modeling style by using the above convergence. How? By using 2:1 mux as a component. Okay, so you can practice structural modeling style at least 7 times by converting. Okay, so in this case, what will happen is, this particular multiplexer will be your child entity, or in VHDL terms, it will be your component, and you can use this particular component to realize 7 different parent entities. Okay, so you can use multiplexer as a component, and you can connect the child's first input to B and the second input to VCC, and you can realize an OR gate. Similarly, in this particular case where we converted multiplexer into a NAND gate, we will have two components. The first component will be a 2:1 multiplexer, and second component would be a inverter. Okay, now the question or the challenge in this is that how do you connect permanently one of the inputs of a child entity to VCC? That is what you are supposed to explore. Okay, so now we go to our second topic of discussion. So I leave it to the reader that this particular algorithm, which I showed through examples of NAND gate and an OR gate, you can realize the remaining 5 logic gates using this concept. So now we go to the second topic, that is VHDL modeling of state machines. So I can say that VHDL modeling of state machines is even simpler than behavioral modeling style, because there are standard steps to be done. Now, because we are in final year, like second year students, we are not going to study what is a state machine, what are the different types of state machines, what are the different kind of encodings used, no. But only thing which we know is that state machine is a sequential digital system. So some common things are: state machine is, first, it is a sequential digital system. As I said, the output is a function of present input and passed output. Okay. Second important thing from VHDL modeling point of view, that it is a clock system. That means what? It can either be negative edge trigger, or it can be positive edge trigger. Okay, 1 to 0, 0 to. Third important thing is, because it is a state machine, it will go through fixed number of states. Okay, so state machine is, it goes through finite number of states, which we technically called as FSM. Okay. Fourth important fact is, it compulsorily has a facility to be resetted. Fifth is that can be basically of two types, namely Moore machine and Miele machine. Okay, so five basic facts we have jotted down for a state machine, that it is basically a sequential digital system wherein the output is a function of both present input and past output. It is a clock system and it can be either positive as triggered or negative as triggered. Third thing, that it goes through finite number of states, so it is FSM. Fourth thing, it compulsorily has a facility to be resetted. And fifth is, it can be basically of two types, Moore machine and Miele machine. So why I have specifically wrote down point number 2 and 4 is that whenever we will be drawing a block diagram of the state machine for which we want to write a VHDL model, we are going to show clock and reset as compulsory inputs. I repeat, that point number 2 and 4 has been written specifically to remind us that when we draw the block diagram for a state machine, we are supposed to show reset as well as clock as inputs, and this is compulsorily a asynchronous reset system. Asynchronous reset. And then depending upon what way we want to represent the behavior of this particular state machine in the form of a state diagram, it can either be Moore or Miele type. Okay, so you know basically that Moore and Miele machine, Miele machines takes one state less to achieve the output, while Moore takes one state more. Maybe it requires more hardware, but there are pros and cons for both Moore and Miele machine, right? So for example, this is a small part of some state diagram. Okay, so it is, this state is following something and is going to something. Okay, now who can tell me that if I want this to be a Moore machine state diagram representation and this to be a Miele machine, what can it be? Okay, so we can say that input is X and output is Y. Okay, so this is input and this is output. Okay, fast, any one of you who knows Moore and Miele representation can tell me that if this particular circle has to represent one of the states of a Moore machine and this particular circle has to represent one of the states of a Miele machine, then how should X and Y be written? First. Yes?
Sir, in Moore, inside the circle, we have to write the state, and upon that, we have to write the output.
So say, for example, this state is S1, okay? Yeah, so where to write output, where to write input?
Sir, below S1, output.
Why? Where to write inputs in case of Moore machine?
On the arrows.
Very good. Okay, so we know that this can be either 0 or 1, 0 or 1. Accordingly, we will have branching, right? So when the state machine is in state S1, at that time, the output may be 0 or 1. And when it wants to go somewhere, then if the input comes as 0, it will go to some state. And if it comes 1, it may go to some other state or remain wherever it is. Okay. So if the same notation is supposed to be used in Miele, how will that be?
Sir, on the arrows only, both input and output.
Yes, correct. Okay. So simply by seeing how the state diagram is drawn, we can come to know that whether it is belonging to Moore machine or Miele machine. Okay, so in Moore machine, the name of the state and below that we write the output, and the inputs are written on the connecting branches or the arrows. And in case of Miele machine, the circle contains only the state name, while on the arrows which take the state machine from one state to another, we are going to write down input slash output. This was basics. Okay, now what I will do, I will flash to you a particular state machine and we will see how to do the coding. Is this visible to you? Is the PPT visible to you?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Right. So these are the steps which are to be followed for VHDL coding of state machines. Create a block diagram out of the state diagram. Okay. So from the state diagram, whether it is a Moore machine or Miele machine, we can clearly find out that the input signal and output signal, they are represented by which alphabets. Say for example, the input is detected as being X and output detected as Y. So in the block diagram, at least you can show that, okay, fine, this particular system, this particular black box, it represents a state diagram or a state machine, and it is having inputs X and output Y. And in addition to that, by default, you have to add two inputs, that is reset and clock. Please remember one thing, that if a particular state machine has n number of inputs, then actually in the block diagram, it will have n plus two inputs, because in addition to the n inputs, you have to add reset and clock there. Fine. So second is create a new data type in declaration section of architecture body. This is something new I will tell you. Okay. So just like in structural modeling style, in the declaration section of architecture body, you will actually create all individual child entities or components, and then you will define the intermediate signals or connecting signals. And then in the logic section, then you will do component instantiation and port mapping. And then you will subsequently go on writing the entity declaration and architecture body pairs of each and every component which you have used to build the parent. So similarly, a little different type you have to do, not that complicated. So here you have to create a new data type in declaration section of architecture body. I'll not tell the details. When I tell you, you will come to know. So define the signal belonging to the above data type. So here we are going to learn how to create user defined data types in VHDL, like bit, standard underscore logic, integer, constant, time. These are all predefined data types. But if you want to have an enumerated data type like in C, this is what you are going to learn today. Okay, so create a new data type in declaration section of architecture body. Define a signal belonging to the above new data type you have created. Next, use process clause, that is a logic section of architecture body. Use case construct within the logic section, and if then else if and if within this. Okay, fine. This is appearing as a theory. So when we start writing the model, you'll come to know, even if you don't know this, these six steps. So this is the block diagram. This is the state machine for which we plan to code it. Okay, so I will try to do something. So are you able to see the PPT and the OneNote next to each other?
Yes, sir.
Okay, fine. So what I will do, I will draw this particular state diagram here. So we see here. Okay, so what I will do is that I will first see that when in the state A, W equal to 1, it goes here, W equal to 0. Right? State B, if it gets W equal to 0, it goes to state A. If it gets W equal to 1, it goes to state C. Okay. Similarly, if it is in state C, if it gets W equal to 1, it remains there. And if while remaining in state C, if it gets W equal to 0, it goes here. Okay, so simple. Okay, so first we will read this state diagram like this. Okay, so you see here in the state diagram, they already shown a reset. That means what? If our system receives a reset in whichever state it is, it will return to the state A. So this particular state diagram has three states having names A, B, and C. I repeat that this particular state machine, which is represented here as a state diagram, has three valid states with names A, B, and C. So when the system receives a reset, it will return to state A. Now, when it is in state A and it receives input equal to 1, it goes to state B. If in state A it receives input equal to 0, it remains in A. If the system is in state B, if it receives input equal to 0, it goes to state A. If it receives input equal to 1, goes to state C. If the machine is in state C, if it receives input equal to 0, goes to state A. If it receives input equal to 1, it remains in state C. And we see that in states A and B, the system's output is equal to 0 and its output equal to 1 only when it is in state C. Okay. So now from this particular state diagram, I should be able to make the correct block diagram of the system. So as we know that block diagram, whenever you draw a block diagram, it is ultimately the correct starting point for making the entity declaration, writing the entity declaration. So what I will do is that I will give one name to this. I will say state MC. Let the name of this entity be state MC. Now, who can tell me that from this particular state diagram, can anybody tell me the input and output names? Because from this, we have to find out that what are the names of the input signals. Yes, apart from Yash, others can answer. Yeah, anybody other than Yash should answer. So from this particular state diagram and understanding how Murey machine is represented, you should be in a position to tell me that which are the inputs and outputs of this system. Yes. Hrithik, 42447. Hrithik should reply. Hrithik, unmute yourself and reply to my question. Hrithik, 42447 must immediately reply. Am I not audible?
Audible, sir.
Hrithik, you are not replying. If you don't reply now, you will be removed from the meeting. If you don't reply to the query, it is assumed that you have just joined the class but are not in frame. You are not in front of the screen. Hrithik Magnani, this is the last call. If you don't reply, you will be removed from the meeting. Okay, Kisle Chandra, 431. If you want to remain in the meeting, you have to answer.
Sir, I don't know the answer, sir.
You should know the answer. This is a second year question. Don't say don't know the answer. I already explained that how a state diagram is classified as Murey machine and Miele machine. Also, we have told here that in a Murey machine, how is the output and input represented in the state diagram? It is there here. See here. In Murey machine, it is there. Now tell me that the input signal is represented by what? Where is input signal? Tell me, Chandra.
Sir, X is input.
X is input. That is for an example in this particular thing. Yeah?
Once.
Yeah. See. In Moore machine, the input signal is written on the branch. So here, see here, which alphabet w. is written?
W on the.
Very good. Yes. So the state machine's input is W.
W.
Yeah. Okay. So from the state diagram, we can come to know that W is the input. Okay. Yes. What is output represented as? Yeah. So output is in a Moore machine. Output is written inside the circle. So can you tell me from this which alphabet represents output?
Z, sir.
Z. Okay, Z. So output is Z. Okay. Yes. So from the state diagram and its relationship with the Moore machine representation, the machine has an input denoted by W and output as Z. Any other thing? Any other inputs? What is the rule I told you? If a state machine has n inputs from the state diagram, you have to add how many inputs to it? Chandra?
Sir, can you repeat, sir?
My question is, if a particular state machine has well-defined n inputs, that how many total inputs does it have? How many inputs do you need to add to the default inputs in case of a state machine?
N, sir.
N plus n, so 2n, huh?
Yes, sir, 2n.
2n, huh? Okay. Who can correct his answer? Is his answer correct? Pooja Ghotis, 420, reply.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, how many additional inputs do you need to show on the block diagram of state machine?
Sir, 2n, sir.
2n? Wrong. 2n. Shweta Vairalkar, 468, reply. How many inputs you should add to the existing inputs in a state machine? I told you. I told the whole class.
2n, sir.
2n. I already told 420's answer is wrong. Why you told the same wrong answer? What is the point in repeating the same answer, wrong answer? Venkatesh Parikh, 469, reply.
Sir, 2 raised to n.
What you people are hearing, God knows what you are hearing when you attend the class. Vijay Kumar Somamanchi, 471. Vijay Kumar Somamanchi, 471, reply.
Yes, sir.
Yes, how many additional inputs by default should you add in a state machine's block diagram? Yes, kitna add karenge aap?
Two, sir.
Two, very good. Which two? Can you name them? यहाँ पे आपको कौन कौन से दो इनपुट्स ऐड करने हैं? ठीक है, अच्छा आपने आधा तो आंसर किया. प्रज्वल इज रेजिंग हैंड. प्रज्वल बताओ.
सर, रीसेट एंड क्लॉक.
वेरी गुड. ओके, सो आउट ऑफ दीज टू डिफॉल्ट इनपुट्स टू स्टेट मशीन, रीसेट इज फॉर्चुनेटली शोन हियर. ओके, सो यूजुअली वी नो दैट रीसेट शो समथिंग लाइक दिस. सो प्रज्वल, रीसेट को कैसे दिखाऊं? एक्टिव हाई दिखाना है तो कैसे दिखाना है? एक्टिव लो दिखाना है. मुझे एक्टिव लो रीसेट दिखाना है तो कैसे दिखाऊंगा मैं, बताएंगे?
एक्टिव लो,
मेरे रीसेट सिग्नल का नाम आरएसटी है और मुझे दिखाना है तो कैसे दिखाऊंगा कि वो एक्टिव लो है? अच्छा, अगर मैंने इसको ऐसे दिखाया तो एक्टिव हाई हुआ, एक्टिव लो हुआ?
सो एक्टिव लो, आई गेस.
You are wrong. It's not active blue. Lokesh Harchandani, 436, reply. मुझे अगर अभी RST दिखाया हमने, ये जिस तरह RST दिखाया हमने, एक्टिव हाई या एक्टिव लो है?
सर, एक्टिव हाई. हेलो,
सुन रहा हूँ, सुन लिया मैंने. आप अपने आप को अनम्यूट कर सकते हैं, म्यूट कर सकते हैं। ये देख लो ध्यान से, देर आर फोर पॉसिबिलिटीज इन डिजिटल सिस्टम। अ पर्टिकुलर एक्टिवेशन सिग्नल कैन बी एक्टिव हाई, एक्टिव लो, पॉजिटिव एज ट्रिगर्ड और नेगेटिव एज ट्रिगर्ड। इसको हम बोलते हैं लेवल ट्रिगरिंग। बताओ यूजुअली हम लेवल ट्रिगरिंग में हम एनेबल यूज करते हैं। यूजुअली ये सिग्नल का हम नाम बोलते हैं एनेबल, और यूजुअली ये जो होता है वो क्लॉक होता है। सो यूजुअली क्लॉक इज द सिग्नल विच एज ट्रिगर्स अ सिस्टम, एंड यूजुअली एनेबल इज द सिग्नल विच लेवल ट्रिगर्स अ सिस्टम। आई रिपीट, यूजुअली EN इज द सिग्नल विच लेवल ट्रिगर्स अ सिस्टम, एंड CLK इज द सिग्नल विच एज ट्रिगर्स अ सिस्टम। अब मुझे आप लोग बताएंगे कि अगर एक्टिव हाई करना है तो मुझे EN कैसे लिखना पड़ेगा। इधर से EN शूट होगा, ओके। और ये जो है दिस इज द वॉल ऑफ योर सिस्टम, ओके। CLK CLK बताओ। चलो वेदांत महाजन 437 यू आर सपोज टू रिप्लाई। वेदांत महाजन 437 अनम्यूट बताइए। EN इज अवर सिग्नल विच लेवल ट्रिगर्स, तो EN का अगर एक्टिव हाई है तो कैसे बताऊं, बताओ। हाउ शुड इट हिट द रेड बाउंड्री
सर? I just joined the lecture 5 minutes ago, so I am not aware.
You cannot join the meeting after 35-40 minutes.
Okay? Yes, sir.
This is not a canteen where you can come in at any time.
Sir, we were having our iron test.
Okay, fine, accepted. Chalo,
bata.
This is a second year question. Vedant, this is a second year question, how to show signal as active high. ये B में नहीं पढ़ाते हैं। बताओ, how should it hit that system? आपको लगता है कि इलेक्ट्रॉन से कोई कंपनी नहीं आएगी, बेसिक्स नहीं पता आपको। भक्ति साना 449 रिप्लाई।
Yes, sir.
पटक से
एक्टिव हाई। हाँ
बोलो ना
सर। नहीं Join? पता
हाँ नहीं पता। बी में आके पता नहीं एक्टिव हाई और एक्टिव लो कैसे रिप्रेजेंट करते हैं। प्रियंका 412 रिप्लाई कीजिए।
यस सर
बोलिए। EN इज टू बी शोन एज एक्टिव हाई सिग्नल, तो द सिग्नल विल हैव टू बी कनेक्टेड टू द बाउंड्री ऑफ सिस्टम इन व्हाट वे। हर जगह बताओ कैसे करेंगे।
सर EN इज एक्चुअली एक्टिव लो ना?
नहीं नहीं दोनों एक्टिव लो यहाँ पे है, एक्टिव हाई यहाँ पे है। तो एक्टिव हाई दिखाना है, इफ एनेबल इज एक्टिव हाई सिग्नल, ये तुम्हारी दिस इज योर सिस्टम्स बाउंड्री। ये तुम्हारे सिस्टम की बाउंड्री, इसके बाद तुम्हारी सिस्टम चालू होती है। अच्छा अगर मैंने यहाँ पे अगर मैंने यहाँ पे बबल दिखाया, बबल दिखाया तो एक्टिव हाई होगा एक्टिव लो होगा?
एक्टिव लो होगा सर।
हाँ मतलब गलत कर दिया ना फिर। मिटाना पड़ेगा है ना, इसको मिटा लेंगे। सब कुछ मिट गया। ओके यहाँ पे बबल दिखाना पड़ेगा ना तो एक्टिव लो हो जाएगा। ठीक है, अभी मुझे पॉजिटिव वाइज ट्रिगरिंग दिखाना, तो कैसे दिखाऊंगा मैं? हाउ टू शो पॉजिटिव वाइज ट्रिगरिंग? अपने काउंटर्स के ब्लॉक डायग्राम्स बनाया है ना, उसके बाद वीएचडीएल मॉडलिंग भी किया आपने प्रैक्टिकल में। प्रियंका आई एम स्पीकिंग टू यू।
Yes, sir.
Yeah, Priyanka 412. You have done VHDL modeling of counters. और मैंने क्लास में पढ़ाया है कि एज ट्रिगरिंग को कैसे दिखाते हैं, याद है आपको?
Yes, sir.
तो बताओ फिर कैसे करते हैं? निलेश 404. Fast.
Hello, yes, sir. Sir, triangles, you know.
तो ऐसे बनाना है राइट?
यस
सर। नेगेटिव स्टिकरिंग के लिए कैसे करेंगे?
देयर विल बी ट्रायंगल विद बबल।
ओके परफेक्ट। ओके ध्यान से देख लो सब लोग के यहाँ पे कह रहे हो इरेज नहीं हो रहा है समाउ, तो पॉजिटिव लेवल ट्रिगरिंग में बबल नहीं होता है। तो एक्टिव हाई मींस नो बबल, एक्टिव लो मींस बबल। एस ट्रिगरिंग मींस इट इज ट्रायंगल, सो देयर इज ओनली ट्रायंगल इट इज पॉजिटिव एस ट्रिगरिंग, बबल एंड ट्रायंगल इट इज नेगेटिव एस ट्रिगरिंग। ये बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट है, इसलिए हम अगर एज्यूम करेंगे कि हमारा जो सिस्टम है इट इज हैविंग पॉजिटिव एस ट्रिगरिंग, तो फिर हमको रीसेट के बाद और एक सिग्नल लगाना पड़ेगा CLK, ये डिफॉल्ट होता है और ये होगा पॉजिटिव एज ट्रिगर्ड। ओके तो हम क्या करेंगे, हर बार हमको एक्टिव लो सिग्नल की आदत गिरती है, इसलिए हम जानबूझ के हमारे रीसेट को है वो हम एक्टिव लो बनाएंगे। ओके सो नाउ माय स्टेट मशीन हैज द नेम स्टेट अंडरस्कोर MC. There are three input signals RST, W and CLK. और यहाँ पे हमको पावर हायरार्की डिफाइन करनी पड़ेगी। You have to define power hierarchy here. Power hierarchy जब तक define नहीं करेंगे तब तक we will not be able to say whether the reset is synchronous or asynchronous. जैसे मैंने बताया था reset is always asynchronous. इसलिए power hierarchy में हमारा first signal आएगा RST, दूसरा सिग्नल जो आएगा वो आएगा क्लॉक, और तीसरा सिग्नल जो आएगा W आएगा। ओके इसका मतलब हमको चेक करना पड़ेगा स्टेटस 1। ओके सो चेक स्टेटस इन दिस ऑर्डर। ठीक है, सो So this will be the agenda for the next lecture. Okay. So students के लिए practice ये है कि write VHDL models for all This is a practice work for all of you. Okay. If anybody has any questions, they can stay back or others can leave. So before I end the meeting, if anybody has any questions to ask on the topic discussed today, they can remain in the class or others can leave.